Welcome to episode 14 of the Flame and Fiber podcast. My name is Barbara, and this is a podcast about knitting and sometimes spinning and sometimes lamp working. But it's Christmas time, and now it's time for Christmas knitting, so it's all about knitting. But I am yearning to spin, and I am having plans for the lamp working studio. So eventually there'll be more of those things, but right now it's knitting. For those of you who are new, welcome. Thank you so much for checking out the podcast. I really appreciate it. And for those of you who are coming back, welcome back. Thank you so much for coming back. It really makes me so happy to know that you'd like to spend time with me. So I really appreciate it. And thank you so much to the people who have subscribed and the people who have joined the group. Not too much going on in the group right now, but I'll talk about my cal. Ooh, I'm going to make a note. Talk about my cal at the end of the podcast that I'm, ooh, itchy ear, having with Sharon from the Moms with Yarn podcast starting in January. So things will be happening in the group, so please join it. It's the Flame and Fiber podcast group on Ravelry. And I just want to say welcome. Thank you so much for stopping by. For those of you who are new, lamp working, which is one of the things I do, is the art of making beads or other things out of melted glass that's melted on a torch. And one of my earlier episodes, I did do a little film clip of me making some beads. And so you can see how that works. And I'll try to figure out. I'll put it down here at the bottom, which episode that is that has the lamp working piece at the beginning. And I am planning on doing some lamp working, or at least making some stitch markers or progress keepers with the beads that I've already made. It is cold out in my lamp working studio, which has no heat. Although it's got a kiln and a torch, so it does get a little warmer than the outside temperature, but when it's really cold, it's really cold. But I'm planning on going to Vogue Knitting Live. I talked about this in one of my previous episodes. I'm very excited, and, you know, I haven't really been thinking about it too much because, of course, Christmas, and, I guess my ear is itchy. I'm so sorry. Things like that, it's kind of not been exactly on my mind, but I'm going to Vogue Knitting Live. I'm staying at the Marriott Marquis where the event is taking place, and I am taking three classes. I'm taking Fair Isle Socks with Mary Jane Mucklestone, who's a big Fair Isle guru. And so learning how to do color work is on my list of 2017 knitting goals. So that's exciting. And I'm taking a class with Vera Velimaki, who is a wonderful designer. And it's all about shawl shapes. So I'm thinking, you know, I don't know if I'm a knitting designer or not. Probably not. But, you know, you need to learn things like that. And then I'm taking a dyeing class with Felicia Lowe, who is the dyer behind Sweet Georgia in Canada. And it's a dyeing class for how to dye fiber. So I'm excited about that. So anyway, that's coming up, and I'm really excited about that. And last year they had a podcasters meetup. I know that because I was watching podcasts, and Jacqueline from Brooklyn Knit Folk, and Kristen from Woolenvine, and Jenny from Tiny Paper Foxes. Well, they're handmade in woolen now, and they're not in New York City, so they may not be doing that. And Eric from Sticks Plus Twine, who was there last year. Anyway, they met up. So I'm hoping that somebody who's local to New York is kind of organizing something. I think it was at a bar or a pub or something last year. So I'm hoping that somebody does something this year so that, you know, I can go. And so I want to make some swag, just like I did with Rhinebeck. It'll be different swag, because some of the same people will be getting my swag. They may not want to get the same thing over and over. But I was thinking I'd do something, little progress keepers or something. So I'm planning on having some swag. So if you are at Vogue Knitting Live and you see me, please, please introduce yourself. I would so love to meet you. And, you know, meet you in person, because it's so fun to hear from you. Thank you so much to the lovely people who left me comments or sent me messages. I love getting those. I love hearing from you, and I would love to meet you. So if you are going to be at Vogue Knitting Live, let me know, and we can plan a meetup, sit and knit together, have a drink, eat lunch, something, you know. So I'm taking three classes, but I'm taking one class each day. So I'm taking afternoon class on Friday. I'll take the train up Friday morning. I'll have an afternoon class on Friday, and I think a morning class on Saturday, and then the morning class on Sunday. And I'll take the train home on Sunday at late afternoon. Unless I have dinner plans. I don't have any plans right now. I have a room. I have my room reservation, and I have my classes, and I have my day passes to the shopping, whatever it's called, the vendor area, and I'm getting really excited about thinking about that. So if you're going to be there, please let me know. I would love to meet you and to sit and chat and have and knit. You know, want to knit. Oh, I didn't bring my socks. Well, I didn't knit very much on my socks. Just this is the way the mind works. You know, I'm thinking, well, I'm going to bring socks, but you know, because I'm sitting here talking to you and while I'm mentally packing my knitting for my trip. Sorry. Squirrel. Anyway. So please, please, if you're going to Vogue Knitting Live, let me know. I'm wearing some hand knit. This is not new. I knit this before I started podcasting. Confession time. I wanted to wear something that you hadn't seen, and nobody's seen this because I just wove in the ends this morning before I started podcasting. But I did, and there were only two ends. It's crazy. So this is made out of, and I was trying to figure out what the content of this is. I know it's got linen and merino. This is hand spun. I spun this yarn. Let me start at the beginning. I spun this yarn myself. It's hand spun, and it's got linen in it. So it's not rough, but it's not soft. Like, you know, some of these yarns are like kitty soft. You know, you feel like you're petting a cat. You know, it's pretty soft. So I guess it's maybe softening up the linen. You know, I thought the linen made it feel a little scratchy, but actually it's really nice. It's got merino and linen, and I'm not sure what else. And I have lost my notebook. This what's around me is piled high with stuff. Every time I podcast, I put more in. I just put a new layer. I have to clean this up. This is one of my goals between Christmas. Between this podcast and my next podcast is to spend a little bit of time straightening up. Or before New Year's. Let's put it that way. New Year's is my next podcast. Yes, between now and my next podcast. So I have a book where I was kind of keeping track of my spinning, which would tell me what, you know, would have the label from this fiber. It's Nunoko. Is the Etsy shop that I got it from, and they are in Europe somewhere. Europe is a big place. I want to say Germany, but I'm not positive, but they have some amazing, amazing fibers. I don't think this had milk in it, but it might have. It might be like linen and wool and milk. Because I bought a huge bag of wonderful, amazing, strange fiber. Anyway, so this is, I wrote this down. This is the Summer Flies shawl by Donna Griffin. And I just, this knit up so fast. But it's a pretty little Shawl, it's a shawlette, I guess, because this is definitely just something that's going to go around your neck. Does it, you know, I mean, well, maybe if you're very tiny, it can do something around your shoulders, but it won't do anything for my shoulders. So this is for around my neck. And it feels not exactly summery because of the linen, but, you know, it doesn't, it's not, it doesn't feel super woolly like this is a spring or fall item, I think, but you hadn't seen it, so I thought I would wear it. Oh, the other thing I'm wearing. Oh, you can kind of see. Are my new glasses. I got new glasses. And I got anti-glare. So I think the glare's a lot better. I wonder if I have any of my crummy old glasses here. I could show you the difference. I should have much less glare. Although I can see that I'm wearing glasses, but it's not like it was. So anyway, that's for you. That anti-glare, because I don't wear these outside. This is totally, I'm like, I'm a podcaster now. I need, you know, they're like, oh yeah, this is what they wear, like the newscasters wear. So I got new glasses. Ooh, I'm drinking coffee out of my red cup like I always do. Oh, it's the morning. Oh, did I say it's Monday? Monday morning, December 19th. December 19th, and this is episode 14, and I'll calm down and try to be a little more organized. I'm sorry. These are, like I said, new glasses. My husband and my mother-in-law and I all had eye appointments. We go to an eye doctor about 45 minutes from where we live, and Dennis and his family have gone to this eye doctor for the past 55 years. Now, originally they went to his father, and then he joined his father's practice. So they've gone to this practice for 55 years. So that's why, you know, he knows them. But it's a long drive. And so Dennis's mom doesn't like to do it herself. And his dad was going to come, and he bailed. So it was just the three of us. But Dennis didn't need new glasses, but I did, and Aura, his mother's name is Aura, needed new glasses. So when they were in, we were having, you know, we decided we would have a girls' day out. Dennis wouldn't have to come, and we'd go and have lunch or whatever. So she made an appointment for both of us for last Tuesday at 11 o'clock, which worked out great because then we could have lunch, you know. So on Saturday, I get an email reminder that my hair appointment is at 11 o'clock on Tuesday. I'm like, ah! Well, for some of you understand that, you know, getting my hair done is like a really important, I mean, my hair, I have like the worst hair. My hair, I mean, you know that. I have no hair. I'm practically bald. So, you know, it looks a lot better when it's been done. And, you know, as it is, my timing is bad because I usually get it done on Tuesday, and I usually do this podcast on Sunday or Monday, so it's like never like fresh. It's, you know, anyway. So I had to change my appointment from last Tuesday, and they couldn't take me until the 29th. So luckily, this is my last podcast before New Year's, so this is as bad as it's going to get. But you know, some of you are sitting there saying, so what? You know, you changed your appointment, what big deal? But some of you understand, you know, it's like getting your hair done, it's big. I negotiated my hair when we retired and we were doing allowances and things. That's important. When I was working, I was, I don't know, seems like there's always a, you know, the big emergencies always happen at the end of the day. And one of the projects had a big emergency, and the woman who was responsible for it, I was her supervisor, and she came in and she said, Barb, we need to do this, and we need to do this, and we need to do this, and I have a hair appointment. You understand? I said, I do understand. I'll take care of it. Go ahead, go. I was going to be working late anyway, but I did understand. But I didn't want to rearrange my eye appointment with my mother-in-law because it was all set and she had, you know, done it. And, you know, it's my fault. It wasn't on my calendar. So anyway, That's a really long story to say. I got my new glasses and I had a lovely lunch with my mother-in-law last Tuesday, but I did not get my hair done. But next time you see me, I will have fresh hair. And that will be good. So anyway, why don't we do some knitting? I've been doing knitting. I've been doing Christmas presents and birthday presents. My daughter was a planned baby, as was my son. But it was very poor planning on our part, and her birthday is December 28th. I don't know what I was thinking. Poor child. So she spent her whole life having her birthday 3 days after Christmas. So these are for her birthday. These, and you haven't seen these because I knit the majority of these socks months ago. Months and months ago. I mean, I think I had her try them on in June to see how long I should make them. I had her try them on so long ago that I forgot what the answer was. So I'm hoping these better because I didn't write it down. This is Hermione's Everyday Sock. And I don't have a project page for this. I mean, I had to look at it and say, what the heck am I doing? Because I couldn't find the pattern, but it turned out it was Hermione's Everyday Sock. So you can always find the pattern. I love how this has striped. This yarn is Misty Alpaca, but I don't remember the colorway and I couldn't find the ball band. And I don't have a project page for it. I don't understand why, but I'm behind on my project pages. So anyway, I'm really happy with how they turned out. I do have a cardboard of her foot, a la the Fish Lips Kiss heel pattern. So I'm a little concerned they may be too big for her. But, well, if they are, I can just take them back a little bit. And I kept trying them on the cardboard. I don't know why. I just have some idea that these sock blockers are about her size and they seem to be a little, I don't know. Anyway, I thought they turned out pretty nice. I'm pretty happy with them. They have not been washed and blocked. But I was sitting here trying to figure out what do I need to do, you know, to finish up my gift knitting. I am in no danger of not making my gift knitting because I think I only have, I need to sit down and figure it out. I have to finish my son's mittens, which are here, still piled from last week. Because I sat down and thought about it, my daughter and her boyfriend are arriving at our house on Wednesday. Today's Monday. They're coming on Wednesday. So it occurred to me that I can be knitting on everybody else's presents while they're here, but I can't knit on their presents. So I decided I would need to finish theirs. So I finished Christy's birthday socks. I finished her hat. I've shown you that. That was the suffragette hat. The problem with her hat, I'm trying to figure out where to put these. It's not blocked yet, and I need to block it and Allison's hat. But I got balloons. I got balloons. So I'm blocking it for the first blocking is going to be on balloons. And then if the little welts, I thought I had them right here. Yes. If the welts, this is the suffragette hat that I made Christy, and I made one for Allison too from my I dyed this. But anyway, these welts need to be sort of organized when you block it. See, you know. So I'm hoping the balloon works for the main blocking, and then I have this. I bought this specifically to block that, but it's too small for the main blocking. It's only 20 inches, I think. But it's I can stick pins in it. So I can once I've blocked the hat the first time, I can maybe do something with the welts. But I got to do that today because it's got to be done by Wednesday. So the other thing I finished are the they look terrible, and you know, they're finished but they're not finished. This is the men's loafer slippers felted knit is what it's called. And these are the ones that the yarn hoarder has been showing. And so I made these. Wow, you can see right through there. Can you see that? Did you see? I saw that when I was looking. I was like, oh my gosh, you can see right through it. All right. So that settles that. These need to be refelted. I dried them and whatever, but I'm not happy with sort of how they look. This is made out of wool of the Andes yarn, worsted. And you're supposed to put them in a laundry bag and throw them in with a bunch of other stuff so they get beat up. But when I took them out of the laundry bag, they were all in a ball on themselves like this. And so the tops, I felt like the tops didn't get very felted. And it obviously didn't get felted enough because you could see right through that one. So anyway, I'm going to refelt these to try to get rid of this. You know, you shouldn't have quite so much stiff definition. It should be more like that. I mean, you know, that's what I'm looking for. Something felt like felty like that. And this is like too much. So I think I need to refelt these. I'm not happy with how they look. I do have suede patches to put on the bottoms of them. And I think they're going to be nice, but I'm going to try again. I do have a cardboard foot of riches too. So I don't really need them to shrink too much, but I do want them to felt better. So if they shrink a little bit and I have to stretch them, I'm fine with that, but that doesn't look good. So these are going back in the washer today. And I'm not going to put them in that little laundry bag because I think that kind of forced them into kind of rolling up inside the felt thing. But this is wool of the Andes, worsted. And the colorway for those is Pumice Heather. And it's a nice yarn. This is the first time I've used Wool of the Andes, this whole set of knitting that I'm doing. And I quite like it. And I don't know, do you guys find it itchy on your neck? Because I kind of like the colors. I'm doing something that's not quite finished. So it's not a finished object. That I really enjoyed knitting and made me think maybe I should do something else with Knit Picks Wool of the Andes. And I should, but not for a while. All right, so those are the two presents that I finished. I decided to wait and do the bunny for my granddaughter, Sammy. Last, because it'll be a lot of fun and I can do that when my daughter Christy's here. But I did make my little socks. I've been doing my advent. This is number 16. I'm not going to put these in any order, but I did my little sock. This is kind of a pretty color. It's green. And then here's one that's blue. It's a bright blue. And these are both sparkly. Quite a few of these socks are sparkly. This is day 18. So this was yesterday. And that's a pretty blue. And this is a fun color. This was day 12. I just broke my thing getting it off the tree. So I kind of liked that. Day 12. And these are the 25 skeins of Christmas from Legacy Fiber Arts. And I've been having Dennis put each one in a box and this is today's. And I haven't looked at it yet. So I thought I'd open it for you guys so you could see it too for the first time. So Dennis has been putting them in here so I get my surprise. I had to unfollow Chelsea because she kept showing the day next days. This is day 15. Pretty pink and orange. Hope I've got them all. I quite like this one. This is purple and gray. Maybe Isabel's right. Maybe gray is my favorite color. I don't think so, but I did. The other ones, there were a lot of pastels. And, you know, most of the yarns are not particularly complex. So this is nice. This has got a little bit going on. A little more saturated color, a little more of a combination. This was day 14. And I don't know if I missed any. And this one was really nice. I really liked this one. This had something going on. It was also a gray base, but I don't think that's why I like it. I mean, look at the colors in there. You know, this has got something going on. A lot of them are kind of, you know, they're nice. They're nice colors. But this is more interesting. Much more interesting. This color. So, is that 7? 2, 4, 5, 6, 7. Yep, 7. So, those are the little socks that I made. I'm really enjoying having those socks on my tree. But I do have to say, I mean, each of those socks takes me an hour and a half to make. Maybe I'm slow. I don't know. But, so by the time I'm done, I'm going to have spent 36 hours of my Christmas knitting time knitting these little socks. But I do love them. And I am going to, there are a few, I haven't sent my Christmas card yet. And I'm thinking that a couple of these are going to be tucked into a Christmas card as a little treat for special friends. Okay, here I are, 19. This is today's now. I'm liking this one, too. I just want to, you know, a little something going on. I mean, it's a mini. One of these, they used, like, the tiniest amount of ribbon they could possibly use. These are not set up so you can actually hang the ornament. You have to come up with your own hanging plan. So this is day 19. Trying to get this out, and I want to show you, I got a trick from, actually I've seen a couple people talk about it now, but the first people I saw talk about it were, Sue and Andy, Sue from Legacy Knits, who I bought this set from, and Andy from Andre Sue Knits. They've been doing some podcasting together. They're doing a project together, a spin. Welford Pearls calls them spackles, spin, and you know, spin along, knit along. And so they're talking about spinning a sweater's quantity and then knitting a sweater. And we're invited along. So I'm actually tempted by that. Now this is pretty. This is the yarn. I like this a lot. Well, that's fun. Because some of them I'm like, ugh. But this, I really like. Oh, look how the light changes when I put that close to the... I don't get any focusing, you know, like a real camera does. I'm doing this on my phone. But I think that's beautiful. But the way I'm doing this is, all these are still in their skein instead of a ball. My first day, I balled up the thing, and that took a lot of time. It was kind of a mess, and I did a bad job. And then, and I had to ball one other one up, because when I tried my thing, it didn't work. But basically, I've been putting it around my neck, like this, like a necklace. And then I just unwrap it and do my knitting and unwrap it and do my knitting. And it works out great because this is nice and big and it goes over my neck. Now, if it were smaller, they say to put it over your wrist and just, you know, so that's what a lot of people are doing for their mini whatevers. So they don't have to ball up their little tiny skeins. I mean, it takes a lot of time to ball those up. And, and they look so pretty in this game. So this goes back in this game. But at first I have to knit my sock today. Put it on Instagram. So anyway, so I'll give this give this back to Dennis with the big box, and he'll put 20 in, number 20 in for me, and I'll open it tomorrow. So that's worked out really well, considering how upset I was when I discovered it was in clear plastic. So anyway, so that's what I have been knitting and finishing. And what I have, I did work on my socks, and but I'll show you those next time. I might have them finished by next time. I didn't work a ton on the socks because I was mostly working on the slippers and the socks for my daughter. And then I decided my mother has cold feet. And I am giving her a pair of socks, which need to be, which I knit quite a while ago, because I had thought about giving them to her for something else. These are just plain, oh no, I did some kind of striping of effect there. And so these are, the color is gooseberry, but I don't remember. I'll put it down here, who this yarn is. It's soft and yummy. And so her feet will be warm after I put it. Oh, and I don't usually do contrasting heel and toe. Maybe I was worried. I think this might have cashmere in it, so I might have been worried about the strength and durability, so I put something else in. But I don't remember what the heel is. For sure, I don't know. Actually, I have a project page for these socks, so I'll be able to tell you, but I'll put it there. So these are for my mother, and then I started to think, her feet get cold, you know, and I had a pair of socks. Last year was the first year I made socks, and I had a pair of socks that I wore a hole in the heel because I was wearing them around the house like slippers. Like they were warm, and so I didn't have my shoes on and whatever. So anyway, I decided to make my mother the simple house slippers. And the simple house slippers are a pattern that was big last year. And the pattern, I do a modification of the pattern. The pattern looks like this. And it's just garter ridge. You sew that up, the foot goes in here. And it's a nice house slipper. This is also wool of the Andes. But what I do is I make it more like a booty. So when I make this garter ridge, I make it longer. I cast on more stitches. The pattern calls for 40 stitches. So I'm not sure how that works. Is it a bigger yarn? Because I used worsted on this, but I wanted it to be really thick and strong. And I wanted it to be, so I went down a needle size so that I've gotten a real tough fabric. And I added more stitches. So on this worsted, on a size 4 needle, because I'm doing this on a Jiaogu lace size 4, I cast on 80. So these I put on waste yarn, and so I'm going to Kitchener the front of this together, and then I'm going to mattress stitch the back, and then you put your foot in here, and you have a house slipper. And I just decided this at the spur of the moment, and I had bought a bunch of wool of the Andes for making Christmas ornaments and things like that. And so I had these two colors, which I thought went beautifully together. So I just had one ball of each, and it takes, each sock takes a 50 gram ball each, especially the way I do it. I mean, I'm playing yarn chicken with this toe. I got to do this toe, 7 rows of decrease. I don't know if I'm going to make it. I have a tiny little bit of the blue. This is it. This is all I have left. But I, you know, so they're exactly the opposite at the moment, But if I need to, I may have to put a little more, if more blue at the tip of this toe. If somehow those were not the same size, because I weighed the one that I finished and it was 48 grams. So if I got slighted in the least with that red, I'm not going to make it. So the colors, these two colors, these are Innit Picks Wool of the Andes, and we have Bouquet Heather and Bramble Heather. Those are the two colors. And I guess your guess is as good as mine, which one's bouquet and which one's bramble. Bouquet would be the red, maybe, and bramble the blue. I'm not sure. Or gray. It could be called a gray. But I'm making these for my mother. I'm going to give them to her in addition to the socks so that she can put wear these. Not that they go together or anything. Those two. Here, Ma, here's a set. Oh well. She'll love them. And she will have warm feet, and that will be fun. So this is one work in progress that I'm working on. And I did do a tiny little bit on those two socks that I showed you last week, but not enough to warrant me running downstairs and getting them because, well, not too much, but I'll show them again next week. So I guess that's really all I have on my needles. I'm gonna refelt those slippers because they turned out not great. And so for Christmas presents, I have to block the hats. I have to refelt the slippers, and I need to take my waste yarn out of these mittens, and I'm going to knit in a ribbed cuff for these. These are for my son, and those will be nice and warm. And I did the Raleigh giraffe for my granddaughter, but I haven't put his face on yet, so I need to do that. And then I'm going to be doing Bon Bon for my other granddaughter, my new granddaughter, who's tiny. She is 4 months old. She was 4 months old on the 12th. So she's getting Bon Bon. The other thing I have to do before Christmas is this is the first stuffy I ever made. I told you this before. I started knitting, and 2 days later, I found out I was going to be a grandmother. So, some of my early knitting was for Isabel, and Isabel got this. So I started knitting in February, and I knit this in. I finished it in August. She was born in August, and I have him now because he has a boo-boo. And he needs some repairs. And I've actually never repaired anything like this. So I'm not sure what I'm gonna do. The yarn is torn. You can see that I stretched him really wide, so you can even see the white. That's just me not knowing what I'm doing. But anyway, he's pretty adorable, and I'm gonna fix his boo-boo, figure out how to do that, try to knit over it, I guess, like a patch. Well, I could practice on those socks that I wore a hole in that I haven't done anything with. I might do that, just practice on my socks before I fix his boo-boo. So that's my upcoming knitting things that I have to do. I got some things in the mail, I will confess. Oh, I got a pair of Hiya Sharp. I wanted to try them for socks because I couldn't find. I was feeling like I was missing needles. Well, I have two pairs of socks on the needles. This I had those socks for my daughter, and I have another pair of striped socks. I talked about them earlier, I mean, in another podcast, where I need to put in an afterthought heel. And it's a true afterthought heel. It's not a forethought heel. A lot of most people who do an afterthought heel is not really. It's a forethought heel because they decide where the heel's going to go. They put in the waist yarn and they knit it after. It's an after knit heel. But they thought about it beforehand. When I was knitting these socks, I didn't want to think about it. I was in a car ride with my mother. I just want to knit. So I made a tube sock. And it's a self-striping. It's a Felici. But I didn't want to think about where that heel was going to go. And so I stopped at about this much. I think I'm ready to start the toe. But I want to put the heel in before I put the toe in, which I think is something that Susan B. Anderson recommends in her, people have said in her new sock pattern, which I don't own. But somebody mentioned that one of her suggestions in that pattern is before you do the whole toe, put the heel in and then you know for sure whether or not it's the right size. So that's what I want to do. But that's going to be snip, snip, snip because there's no waist yarn in there. I need to learn how to do that. And I want to learn how to do that. I mean, I think it's kind of empowering, the thought of snip, snip, snipping. But something I need to learn how to do. So back when I first ordered my Legacy Knits 25 Skeins of Christmas. Oh, I am really liking this yarn. This is the one from today. I said I had gotten myself two Christmas presents. The mini skeins, which was a big present. But my second present was, came in this, is a little bobbins bag. Now I have a little bobbins bag. I have my little bunny bag is from her. And I love it. It's a little zipper bag. You've seen it many times. But I wanted to get an applique bag if I could. And so I found these in the shop. Now this is a Christmas bag. It's got a little holly on it. But and a little heart. Aren't they adorable? Christmas stocking bag. Little drawstring bag, but I will not be saving this, just only using it at Christmas, I don't think. I mean, I might, but, and it says little bobbins on the back. But this is a beautifully made, it feels lovely, and she's got her Christmas stocking bag by Little Bobbins, and then it's got a little Christmas tree stitch marker. That's attached. So anyway, this was my other Christmas present to myself that I mentioned I had two. Well, it turns out I've been giving myself other things. So Helen and Mary Beth of the Crafty Toads podcast, which I really love. It's one of my favorites. I have a few podcasts that is, you know, as soon as the podcast comes out, I watch. I try to watch it. And they are... their podcast is one of those. I just get such a kick out of them. Very genuine people. And New Jersey. I love it. They've started dyeing yarn. There's their. And their store is called Toad Hollow. You can get it online, Toad Hollow NJ. Look at that toad. And this is on their Drusilla base, which is 80% superwash merino, 20% nylon, 2-ply. And I wrote it here. I'm pretty sure this is called Vintage Candy. They forgot to put the color name on the label. Or maybe they don't do that. I don't know. But I'm pretty sure I ordered Vintage Candy. When I get close to the color changes. But this is pretty close to what it is. These are beautiful, beautiful colors. This feels Christmassy to me. I guess it's the dark green next to the pink. I'm not sure. Maybe I'll think of this as a Christmas color. Isn't that beautiful? So they've started dyeing yarn, and so I wanted to support them. That's why I bought this. Not because it's absolutely stunning. No, that's not why. I love it. Anyway, I'm so excited. And then the other thing, acquisition I have is, I'm sure you recall my mitts. You don't even have to recall them because I have them here. These are the ones I'm giving my sister that I knit. I knit two pair. I've been wearing mine, obviously. I still have ends to weave in before Christmas. I guess I should block these too. So I need to work on these. This is made out of a Cormo yarn, which I loved. I got it at Rhinebeck, which made me realize that I really like Cormo yarn. And then I was watching Michelle Wong's podcast. She used to have Gauge Intention, which it was a yarn shop in Brooklyn that you used to hear about on the Yarngasm podcast and on the Brooklyn Knit Folk. But that store closed, but she's a designer and she, you know, but she has a podcast. And I was watching, I'm sure it was an older episode. It might even been like from August. And she does monthly picks and she picks things that she loves. And this was her monthly pick for the one I watched, which is Elemental Effects, U.S. Yarn Company, homegrown, hand-dyed, and spun in the United States. Now, I got these on D-Stash. So I got a bargain. The jury's still out on the color, and you're not seeing the real color. The color is a bright tealy blue. It's a little more tealy than you're seeing, but it's that bright. But it's just a tad more tealy, I think. Yeah, it's not quite, the color's not quite right. So the jury's still, I mean, I love the color, but it's kind of bright. And I'm not sure, you know. And now that I've had dye classes, my thinking was, well, it's cheap enough that I could overdye it if I end up not liking the color. But it's kind of growing on me, I have to say. So these are big. These are four. Well, they say they're approximately 4 ounces, 112 grams. But I weighed these for my stash management. They're each 125 grams. So at 112 grams... 4 ounces, they're 550 yards stretched, because it is very stretchy yarn. And it's a worsted spun yarn, 2-ply, so 550 yards for 4 ounces. So it's a lot of yarn. So I need to think about, what do I want to do with this? I really love the Cormo, so I bought this. It was on D-Stash. So those were the things that I have acquired. And things that I'm thinking about, I kind of mentioned it last week, although I have a tendency to not finish my sentences. And I know I do that, and I'm sorry. I'm trying to be better, but normally that's not a problem because normally the person I'm talking to is sitting there and saying, so Barb, what are you talking about? So that I can tell them. But I say that to myself as I'm editing, saying, Barb, you didn't finish your sentence. They're not going to be able to read your mind. One of the things that I've been thinking about, I've been really enjoying these granny stripe crocheted blankets, which I think is a brilliant idea for using up the very, very end of every scrap, you know, because the Cozy Memories blanket makes the square, but you still end up with a little bit left over. So it's one nice way to use all of your yarn. So the only problem is, I don't know how to crochet. Now, I suspect that that would be an easy, I mean, I think it's relatively easy. I mean, I've done a single crochet and I watched, you know, Knit and Crochet Now. So I've watched a lot of crocheting on TV. But that doesn't mean I can do it. But I am kind of tempted by these blankets everybody's doing, and I love the idea of using up every last bit of the yarn on something like that. I'm perfect. I know there are some people who want to like knit to the very end. They don't want any scraps left. Since I've been seeing all these lovely scrappy things, I'm perfectly happy to have scraps, you know. And I do want, you know, it's nice to have scraps, and so you can send a mini in an exchange of, you know, from a project that you knit. I mean, I think that's fun. I love getting minis that I think, oh, this is, you know, somebody made socks out of this or something. So I'm fine having leftovers. But it is nice to have ultimately something to show for it. And so, but I do have a memory, Cozy Memories blanket that has about 8 squares in it that I haven't worked on in months and months and months. I would have shown it to you if I'd worked on it since I started this podcast, and I had my third anniversary last week. Third month anniversary. So I haven't done anything with it in th over 3 months for sure, probably more like 6. So, and you know, when I'm thinking about the granny square stripe blanket, I'm thinking, oh, and I can tear those 8 stripes and those 8 squares out, use that yarn. So obviously I'm not really, you know, wedded to the Cozy Memory blanket. But I am thinking about this granny stripe blanket. But I'm feeling like such a copycat because I want to make the granny stripe blanket. And then I'm looking at this Find Your Fade. Has anybody been seeing that? Find Your Fade. I don't know if you're going to be able to see this very well. This is a shawl by Andrea Mowry, and it takes a lot of, let me see if I can get another picture. It takes a lot of yarn. I mean, people are picking 7 skeins. Can you see that? So it's got a little bit of, it's hard to see here, but it's got a little bit of lace work, but it's a huge shawl. I mean, this is wrapped around her twice. It's huge. I think it's like 100 inches big. Let me see if I can see this with my new glasses on. Let's see. See notes for size. Finished measurements. 101 inches, which is 256 centimeters for those of you who are in the rest of the world doing metery things, and 30 inches or 76 centimeters for the center depth. I think it's asymmetrical, but it says it takes 1500 yards, and you can you know do it any The idea is that you're finding yarns that, you know, are related, and you're sort of knitting one into the next, you know, so that the first yarn and the last yarn aren't obviously related, but because they relate to the one next to it, you know, so this one has yellow, and so the next one has some yellow but blue, and so the next one has the same blue but green with green, and then, you know, that kind of thing. So I'm thinking about the Find Your Fade, but you know, it's all over Instagram, and I feel like, you know, I'm torn between feeling like, oh, I want to join this cal. So many people are doing it. It's something that the community's doing. To also, it's like everybody's doing it. You know, do I want to do what everybody's doing? A part of me does, apparently, or I wouldn't even be thinking about it. But the other thing is 1500 yards. That's a big friggin' shawl. That's a lot of knitting. That's a lot of yarn. I mean, it's $100 worth of yarn, 120. By the, you know, I mean, some people are picking 7 skeins. I mean, you're going to have leftovers. There's no two ways about that, but that's a lot of yarn. But what else am I going to do with it except knit it? But I think the thing about the Find Your Fade is I need to decide if I would use a shawl that big. If I would use a shawl that big, then go do it. Why not? You know, participate with the rest of the, you know, the Instagram world and the, you know, other podcasters are going to be doing it, I'm sure. And, you know, it looks like a lovely pattern, but, I need to decide if I would use that shawl. If I would wear it, then why not? But if I'm not going to wear it, then I don't know. I don't think I want to do it. But I do have a confession to make. I am sorry I didn't do the building block shawl by Stephen West. Remember I talked about that? I bought it. I bought the pattern, you know, thinking I was going to participate in the knit-along back in October. And then when I saw the first clue and, you know, he did videos of himself making the first clue, how to make it and everything. And I saw people's first clue and second clue and I'm like, I don't know. But when I saw the finished shawl and the finished shawl on people, I really liked it. I really liked it a lot. So I'm a little sorry I didn't do that. But, you know, I still have a project bag somewhere. It's either back there or downstairs. With the 4 yarns that I picked for that, still in the bag. So it's not too late. I could do that. And I own the pattern. So I could do it for the Knit From Your Library Cal in January. So I could still do that. But I'm trying to decide about the Find Your Fade. I think it would be fun to pick the yarn for that to go through Stash Dive. I wouldn't want to buy any. Stash Dive and find 4 or 5 yarns that, you know, when you put them side by side, they relate to each other and they make a kind of its own version of a gradient. Because you can see, let me see if you can see. How they do that, you know, start with the orange over here, go into yellow, go lighter, then it must be a pink, it must be more pink in there, and then it goes into a darker, dark. I guess my glasses must be doing pretty good with the glare, because you can see the glare there. So, I'm thinking about it, but I haven't decided. It just seems like a lot of yarn. And but I am planning on doing a Christmas Eve cast-on, which is a sock cast-on that Danny of Little Bobbins does every year. And I'm planning on doing that. Although, I'm not sure that I'm going to actually cast on on Christmas Eve. It's not a knit-along where there are prizes or anything like that, so if I don't exactly follow the rule of casting on Christmas Eve, but I follow the spirit of casting on Christmas Eve, I think I'm okay. I can still participate because she has a casual evening on Christmas Eve. They play games and get together on Christmas Eve and she casts on and knits while she's playing games and that kind of thing. But Christmas Eve in our house is my formal Christmas. That's our traditional day of celebrating. My mother is first generation Norwegian American and in Norway, apparently. This is the tradition. So that's been my tradition my whole life. And so I will be having Christmas, you know, my Christmas dinner celebration on Christmas Eve. So I'm also doing it with my parents on Christmas Day. We're driving to visit them. So if I'm not sure I'll get a chance to do my cast on Christmas Eve. I might do it in the car on the way to my parents or something else on Christmas Day. But it'll be in the spirit of the Christmas Eve cast on. And I haven't picked out the yarn for that. So, but that will happen before I podcast next, because I will not be podcasting next week. Next Sunday is Christmas Day, and I'll be at my parents'. And so my plan is to podcast on New Year's Day. My next podcast will be New Year's Day. So I hope you guys have a wonderful 2 weeks. I hope whatever you, if you celebrate holidays at this time of the year, I hope you have a wonderful, wonderful holiday. And I hope you get a chance to do some knitting and do some of the things that bring you joy, but I hope that you're doing what you want for the holiday or for this end of the year. And I wish you a Merry Christmas, which is what I celebrate, and Happy Hanukkah, which is coming up, and Kwanzaa and Solstice, and all those things are coming. And I hope you have a wonderful time. And Happy New Year, because I'm not going to see you until after the New Year. And I'll be thinking about, aside from doing some color work, which is on my goals list for 2017, thinking about my knitting goals and my goals in general. And, you know, we can talk about those. I will give you just a quick rundown. My acquisitions, which are the minis that I opened this week, the Cormo and the yarn from Toad Hollow NJ, came to 496 grams. And the socks, the slippers and the mini socks that I knit and are out, came to 254 grams. So I don't know what I'm going to do about stash management in the new year. That's something I need to figure out, because that brings my total since I got back from my trip and I started this, is I've gained 4 kilos of yarn, 4,009 grams net in. Since I started keeping track. So I might want to just start fresh January 1st. But that's only so it doesn't look so bad, but because I'm going to Vogue Knitting Live and I'm going to be buying stuff there. But I think I'm going to try to buy my yarn live for the most part. I mean, I have 2 local yarn shops. Each of them in opposite directions are about a half an hour from my house, but I don't go to them very often. I buy a lot online. But I also buy at festivals and events and things like that. So if I just buy at festivals and events for the next 6 months, I'm going to be buying it or at the, you know, shop if I need something. You know, so I have Vogue Knitting Live, and then I have Maryland Sheep and Wool at the beginning of May. Think I can do that? I don't know. So I don't know what to do about stash management, but right now And I don't think I'm going to get any more yarn. And I will get more finished. So I will be under 4 kilos by the end of the year, because I'm going to be finishing up and I don't foresee acquiring much more. I mean, I have more minis that I'm going to be, and that's true. And there's a full skein at the end of that too. Day 25 of this advent has a full skein. But still, I think I'm going to have a net outlay in the next 2 weeks because of all the Christmas presents that I have to finish. Of course, I only have a couple. I don't know. So I have to, one of the things I have to think about is, what do I want to do with this? Because I do want to pay attention to it, and maybe I'm just recording it and, you know, we'll see. I'm very deep in the hole right now. Very deep in the hole. So I'll think about it. But anyway, meanwhile, I will see you next year. I can't believe Christmas is next Sunday. And New Year's is less than 2 weeks. So have a wonderful holiday season. Have a very, very happy New Year. I have high hopes for 2017. I am sure it's going to be much better than 2016 for all of us. And I certainly hope so. And I hope you have a wonderful, lovely, crafty time and enjoy the time that you have until I see you again. Thank you. Thank you so much. Thank you for your support in this endeavor this year. I really appreciate it. And I'll see you later. Bye.